edge. So I'm I'm so excited. I didn't really mean to go that deep into it.
No, but that's, I mean, that's something. But that you're
it's what you know, especially since this whole thing hit, man. I mean, since the world got, you know, flipped on its side, man. I mean, that's something I've been excited about. So, well, between the website for the scene and powering clients.
The scene is a huge part of this show, guys. A huge sponsor of the show. I mean, obviously, the founder, the editor. I mean, there's other people involved in the show, obviously. You know, Betsy Ennis is a huge part of the show. But, I mean, John has done so much for this area, and so the scene is just a big part. And so we're always just going to promote and advocate the different things you're doing. And the fact that for your clients, you are, you know, shifting and pivoting for their needs. It's not even about you. It's about them.
No, it's empowering my clients, man.
Absolutely. Yeah. So that is what he's trying to tell you right now is that, hey, guys, like, this is where things are kind of going. This is what's working, and this is what we can provide for you. And so, I mean, yeah, man, tell them about it.
Man, I appreciate the kind words, man.
That's what they need to know about. They need to know that you're actively, you know, working on that stuff. And he is. So,
no, yeah. I appreciate that, man. You know, and whether or not I've done a lot for the community, I don't know, but I am a big cheerleader for this community, man. That's, I mean, man. I call myself a cheerleader, dude. I mean, I love this area. I mean, I grew up here.
Nobody can deny that.
I'll admit I wasn't born here. I came here at age 3 with the space program, you know, but
I was born here, but I've lived in a lot of different places, you know. I haven't lived here my whole life, but I did come back here. I do love this area, and you know, so I think we're both big cheerleaders for this area. Definitely.
Well, absolutely. That's what this whole show's about, man.
Yeah,
we're a cheerleader. We're cheerleaders. Although you don't want to see us in our uniforms, but
nope.
You'd rather hear us. But we're cheerleaders for the waterfront capital of Texas, man.
That's it, man.
That's what this area is, man. I mean, this area is unique and diverse and special, like no other area on planet Earth, man. I mean,
it really is.
Yeah. I mean, you know, and I'll go into one thing real quick, and I think we're going to have to wrap. But this area, literally, you know, there was a Department of Defense survey done after 9/11, and I've told this story before, but I'll tell it again because I'm so proud of it. So this is the only area in America that was more valuable than Manhattan.
Wow.
Because of the diverse – I mean, first of all, we are the home of human space flight. You know, and we are the waterfront capital of Texas, but let me tell you what that means. We have the most, as far as tonnage, the most busy container ports. We have year-round sailing. And that's only Houston. I mean, you know, even Galveston and Texas City, the ports there.
They're building a huge port in Galveston.
Yeah, we've
tourism,
got, you know,
the Royal Caribbean. It's massive.
Yeah, exactly. The whole cruise terminal scenario also, which,
big.
You know, it's taking a little hit right now, but it'll be back.
No, it ain't. It's never going to go anywhere. Yeah. So.
But, you know, you talk about the, you know, there's more engineers per capita than anywhere in the area. I mean, anywhere in the country. I mean,
it's so diverse.
It's such
not even just that it's Houston in general. The Clear Lake is very diverse, but Houston,
energy capital of the world.
Many people have told me that we're more diverse than New York City. And I've had a lot of people argue this with me.
No. Houston's most diverse. Yeah. I mean, I think, what was it? God, what's his name? He just, passed away. You had the show here, the chef.
Oh, Anthony Bourdain.
Sure, I mean, he talked. Yeah. I mean, this
the
is
food is authentic,
literally,
man.
You know, literally, Houston is the most diverse city in America.
Yeah, no, and people don't realize that.
Yeah, I know.
They
just
don't. People just. Yeah, I can't.
And we hear it. We
can't
in the water.
How many people they're like Texas? Oh, Austin.
Right.
I'm like,
or cowboy hats or rednecks.
Austin,
or whatever.
Like,
yeah.
Dude, it's all about Houston, man. That's where
Houston,
it's at.
Dude.
You know.
I mean, you've got the medical center. We've got
largest medical center in the world, guys.
I mean, I'm not saying we have the most Fortune 500 companies in Houston than anywhere, but you know, when the Department of Defense was doing their calibrations, we have enough to check off that box. I think there's more military grade petroleum or you know, oil and fuel processed here than anywhere. I mean, I think it's like literally like 98% of all the military grade fuel.
I mean,
this area is literally, if this area like was, you know, I mean, you know, and this is unfortunate, but you know, if something bad happened to this area, it would mess up the whole country. I mean, this is the most valuable area in the country.
You take out, you know, our nuclear plant. You take out the ship channel. I mean, you know, it could definitely be devastating for the state of Texas.
I've been told by
honestly, not the state of Texas, John. Honestly, so much oil and gas and chemical plants in Houston that there's so much things that are probably plastic in the United States that wouldn't happen if it didn't come through Houston. It affects the whole country, man.
Dude, I mean, I did the
it's wild.
All right, I'm gonna tell you one more story, but back in it's probably like 99 2000, I did a website for a company called American Acreal that just built a big plant there, right there, kind of actually technically right where Seabrook and Pasadena meet, right off of Port Road. You know, and
which is a weird territorial area. Crazy. Pasadena fascinates me.
It was like a joint venture from a Japanese company and a Norwegian company. Anyway, it was just really, really interesting going through that. Oops. But I mean, I'm just telling you that there's so many international things going on here.
Oh,
and
big and, business.
And, yeah,
man.
Yeah.
Big
business. Huge business. Yeah. And, you know, and actually it was kind of a PR thing, you know, back in the day, because people were, you know, and rightfully so. I mean, there's some people that didn't really want more plants. I mean, we have a lot of plants as it is, but, you know, I guess I was on, you know, so I developed that first website, which was kind of half PR, half technical. I mean, it was interesting. Sure. And it was back in the early days of websites. I mean, it was straight HTML code, man.
Yeah, people think websites have been around. I mean, dude, that shit didn't happen until like 1995. You know, like, it's crazy that... I love the fact that I've lived through, there's the Industrial Revolution, I've literally lived through the Technological Revolution, like literally in like 1975 to where we're at today, it's like non-existent to like where we're at.
Oh, it's crazy.
Wow. Like it all happened in like 40 years, like computers, phones, GPS, all of it, man.
Right,
like, it's
right.
Like insane. Yeah, it didn't take hundreds of thousands of years. It all happened like in our lifetimes.
Yeah, what a ride, man.
Oh, dude, and we lived through that.
Yeah,
like I said, I didn't live through the Industrial Revolution. That was cool to live through the 1900s, end of the 1800s, early 1900s. But man, yeah, we've really this technology, man. Computers just. I remember being in school and literally there was one computer lab in the whole school, 20 computers for a whole school. And they were like literally almost as big as the desk that we're like operating out of. They were massive, you know, they were like big old units. Like they were personal computers though.
Man.
It was crazy. They were huge Macintoshes.
I remember visiting my dad. So back in the day, both my parents worked for IBM, you know, and they're both, you know, space program. Actually, they met working on the Apollo program in Washington, D.C. But anyway, fast forward here, they were brought down here for the shuttle program in 76. And I remember over in Nassau Bay visiting my parents, and they had to there was mainframes. I mean, that was the only computer. Yeah. I mean, it was as big as this entire studio, right? I mean,
right.
And they took turns, you know, 24 hours a day that, you know, because there was only one mainframe. And they're writing code for the guidance system for the shuttle. And I remember visiting my dad and looking at all these punch cards.
Yeah.
And he's like, don't let those get out of order.
Wow.
So, yeah, it's interesting. Come just seeing how technology.
Man.
And, of course, you know, I've been, you know, kind of self-employed since, I guess, 97, 98, and the whole, you know, advances in technology from floppy disks to SyQuest disks to zip drives
thumb drives.
A thumb
drive now
can
hold more than a computer could hold.
Truth.
2012, a thumb drive has more RAM on it. That, like, it's like, whoa.
I remember a 40 meg SyQuest drive, which is actually pretty big, hold, you know, 40 megs, and it costs like $200.
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah. So,
and now that's like...
Of course, I remember when the very first digital cameras that the Associated Press was putting out, they cost like $20,000, and they were like 0.3 megapixel.
Yeah, or I remember so when the first plasma, the first plasma TV came out, they were $24,000.
Right.
You know, yeah, like, I don't know, that was 2000, the first flat screen. I meet people and I'm like, man, yeah, like y'all have only, you've literally lived only in a life where you had flat screen TVs. Like we actually used to have the tube, the actual, yeah, like a glass screen.
Dude,
like,
I just recently, during this coronavirus, I put out my last like, you know, tube TV that was like 32 inches. That was like weighed 200 pounds.
I grew up when literally, and I'm not put it out for the guy, trash. But like, yeah, I remember growing up and having a TV that was a piece of furniture.
Yeah.
It was in a wood box. Like it actually like was, yeah. Like,
right.
Put stuff on top of it, you know, like that was crazy. And then how people would put their TVs, their new plastic TVs on top of their wood TVs. Remember that? Yeah, it was just like something to hold the new TV. That was funny.
That's awesome.
All right. Well, man, John.
Dude, that was fun, man.
Yeah, dude, we went off on a tangent.
Yeah, we went all aboard. So if you're listening at home and if you can count how many different tangents we went on, we're going to review the tape and we'll have a beer with you. Maybe there's some other kind of bonus, maybe a gift certificate to a restaurant. Man. We'll figure out a prize. But we want to know how many tangents did Jordan and John go on tonight?
A few. But probably dude,
might take two hands, might take two hands and a friend's hand.
It just goes to show there's a million things to talk about, and we're the guys to bring it all to you, man.
Cheers, buddy.
So cheers to you, cheers to the show. I'm happy to be broadcasting this thing and excited for all the new different things going on.
Man,
so.
I'm just glad that, you know, we can actually do it in person, man.
Yeah.
You know, you know, I'm sick of doing these Zoom shows.
Yeah. No, dude, it's awesome to actually be here in the studio with you. So, yeah, man, that's cool.
So as we mentioned, Scout Bar, Barge 295, the whole Kima District's open, the South Shore Harbor Resort and Conference Center is opening up Friday. In Baytown, the Pirates Bay Water Park, which seriously, that is a underrated, hidden secret water park.
Yes, this is
check
true.
It out, check
yeah,
it out.
Yeah.
You know, there's daily, I forgot what the daily fee is, but you'll enjoy it. You'll enjoy
it.
Yeah,
it's worth it.
And man, so I think we're back on track. We're going to keep this weekly, you know, and maybe Wednesday. I mean, Wednesday with weekends on the water, the whole W thing. I mean, I kind of like
maybe,
that, right?
Yeah, maybe we got to switch it to Wednesdays, man.
You know,
yeah,
the whole Wednesday night sailboat races. I mean, it kind of works, right?
It does kind of work.
Yeah. I was thinking about that on the way over here. So, hey, man, we really appreciate you listening because we know that there's so many other ways you can spend the time.
That's just true. But if you're looking for information in Clear Lake in the Bay Area, we are the guys to get it from firsthand. Definitely subscribe, listen to us live, come into the studio, comment on Facebook. I mean, anything, you know. So,
strongly suggest you follow JETSURF Houston on Facebook because they're loading their dropping a bunch of videos.
We're trying to get that cool content out there, you know. Yeah. So we like to show families and fun on the water, and that's what the show and JETSURF's all about. So yeah,
awesome.
Well, cheers, man.
Cheers
to a great show, and looking forward to next week, brother.
It's Weekends on the Water.
Thanks for listening to today's show.
The official podcast of the waterfront capital of Texas.
Sponsored by Water. Water. Much better than drinking sand.
Weekends on the Water.
Well, we must make you.
Weekends on the Water. With Jordan Davlin of JETSURF Houston and Scene Magazine publisher John Ennis.
Thank you.
It's Weekends on the Water, a show immersed in the people, extreme water sports, real estate, live music, and lifestyle of the waterfront capital of Texas. Weekends on the Water with Jordan Davlin and John Ennis. The official podcast of the waterfront capital of Texas.
We're running this. Let's go. I'm on a boat. I'm on a boat. Everybody look at me because I'm sailing on a boat. I'm on a boat.
Weekends on the Water with Jordan Davlin of JETSURF Houston and Scene Magazine publisher John Ennis. It's Weekends on the Water. Everything from extreme water sports to waterfront dining, real estate, boating, sailing,
yacht clubs,
kayaking,
canoeing,
the lifestyle of the waterfront capital of Texas. It's Weekends on the Water with Jordan Davlin and John Ennis. From the JETSURF Houston studio.
Stop playing with yourself, Hooper. Slow ahead, if you please.
The official podcast of the waterfront capital of Texas.
You're going to need a bigger boat.